Hello friends, how are you? Welcome to My Exam Coaching Classes, and today we are going to learn chemistry. And today's topic is Markovnikov rule and anti-Markovnikov rule. This is one of the very important topic for both 11th and 12th standard students. Okay, you will see the application of Markovnikov rule in 11th standard as well as in 12th standard chemistry. So for both the classes, 11th and 12th, this is one of the very important topic. So many students have confusion. What is peroxide effect? How anti-Markovnikov rule is used, etc. So I am going to clear your doubt in the next few minutes. Okay, you can say 3 to 4 minutes, you will learn what is Markovnikov rule and what is anti-Markovnikov rule, that is peroxide effect, clearly. Okay, so let us learn Markovnikov rule first. So I am writing a reaction here. CH3, CH double bond, CH2. CH3, CH double bond, CH2. What is this item? This is propylene. So let us take propylene react with hydrogen bromide. So you can say in general, an unsymmetrical alkene react with hydrogen halide. You can say HBr, HCl. Okay, here I have taken hydrogen bromide. So hydrogen halide. Okay, so an hydrogen halide react with an unsymmetrical alkene. Here I have taken propylene as the unsymmetrical alkene. When this reaction takes place as per Markovnikov rule. What is Markovnikov rule? Whenever a hydrogen halide react with an unsymmetric alkene, then this hydrogen halide, I am breaking it like this, H plus and Br minus, the negative part of the addendum. What are you adding here? HBr, hydrogen bromide. So what is the negative part of HBr? Br is the negative part. According to Markovnikov rule, the negative part will go to that carbon which have less number of hydrogen. So here this carbon is having 3 hydrogen, this carbon is having 2 hydrogen, this carbon is having only 1 hydrogen. So according to Markovnikov rule, the negative part of the addendum, what is the negative part of the addendum here? Bromine will go to that carbon which have less number of hydrogen. Which carbon have less number of hydrogen here? This carbon have less number of hydrogen here, isn't it? So you can see this bromine will be going with this carbon, and you can write it like this, CH3, the CH and bromine will be added here, this will become CHBr, and the remaining hydrogen will be going with this carbon, and this will become CH3. Okay, so now this double bond is changing to single bond, it breaks, and in such a way, according to Markovnikov rule, what will happen? The negative part, HBr, H plus and Br minus, bromine will go to that carbon which have less number of hydrogen according to Markovnikov rule. And hydrogen will go with this. So you got CH3, CHBr, CH3. What is this item? Isopropyl bromide. So this is isopropyl bromide. So these reactions are known as Markovnikov rule. Okay. So once again, I will tell you students, what is Markovnikov rule? Whenever hydrogen halide react with an unsymmetrical alkene, then the negative part of the addendum, the negative part of what you add, what are you adding here? HBr. What is the negative part? Br. Negative part of the addendum will go to that carbon which have less number of hydrogen. Here less of number of hydrogen is having, this carbon is having less number of hydrogen. So this HBr, Br will be going to this carbon. Okay, Br will be going with this carbon, and it will become CHBr. Remaining H will be adding here to get the valency completed. So CH3 will come here. This item is isopropyl bromide. So this reaction is known as Markovnikov rule. Okay, you can note it, and then we will see what is anti-Markovnikov rule. Okay, you can note it. So can I remove it? Yeah. So I am removing this much. Okay, so again we will see the same reaction once again. What I have taken? CH3, CH double bond, CH2. So this is what? Propylene. You call it as propene or propylene, whatever. Okay, so propylene again react with a hydrogen halide, and we have seen according to Markovnikov rule, the negative part of the addendum will be going to that carbon which have less number of hydrogen atom. Okay, so that was Markovnikov rule. But now what we are going to see, we are going to see what is anti-Markovnikov rule. This anti-Markovnikov rule is also known as peroxide effect. Why? Suppose this reaction takes place in the presence of a peroxide. Suppose this reaction takes place in the presence of a peroxide. For example, I am taking benzoyl peroxide. Okay, suppose this reaction takes place in the presence of a peroxide, then whatever we have learned in Markovnikov rule, the opposite of that effect will take place. What is the opposite of that effect? The opposite of that effect, the negative part of the addendum will go to that carbon atom which have maximum number of hydrogen atom, which have maximum number of, more number of hydrogen atom. That is against Markovnikov rule. That is why we called them as anti-Markovnikov rule, isn't it? So we'll see what happens here. This is the negative part of the addendum is what? Br minus H plus. So Br minus will go to that carbon atom which have maximum number of hydrogen atom. Now you see here, here you have three carbon atom, three hydrogen atom, one hydrogen atom, two hydrogen atom. Here this carbon valency is 4. So valency 4 means 1, 2, 3, 4. It is over. Now no more bromine can be accommodated here because this carbon have valency 4. Out of that valency 4, 3 hydrogen and 1 carbon. So 4 is completed. Here this can be accommodated here only. Okay, so what will happen? This will become like this: CH3, CH, CH2. Now this Br will be added to that carbon atom which have maximum number of hydrogen atom. So CH2 Br will come, CH2 Br, and the H will be going with the this carbon atom. So this will become CH2. So what you are getting? You are getting CH3, CH2, CH2, Br. What is that item? That is N-propyl bromide. So what actually happened here? The negative part of the addendum, Br, goes with that carbon atom which have maximum number of hydrogen atom. So this is against Markovnikov rule. So that is why we call it as anti-Markovnikov rule. Anti-Markovnikov's rule. This anti-Markovnikov rule is also known as peroxide effect because this reaction takes place in the presence of a peroxide. We used benzoyl peroxide here. So this reaction is also called peroxide effect. Isn't it? So what we have learned, students? We have learned two very important reactions which are equally important for your class 11 as well as your class 12. One is Markovnikov rule and the second one was anti-Markovnikov rule, or you can say it as peroxide effect. We will have a quick revision of both. Whenever a hydrogen halide react with an unsymmetrical alkene, the addendum, negative part of the addendum will go to that carbon atom which have less number of hydrogen atom. That is Markovnikov rule first. And if the reaction takes place in the presence of a peroxide, then anti-Markovnikov rule will take place. That is, the negative part of the addendum will be going to that carbon atom which have maximum number of hydrogen atom. So Markovnikov rule, anti-Markovnikov rule. Anti-Markovnikov rule is also called peroxide effect. Very important, students. Prepare well for your exams. We'll meet again with new more reactions and new more rules in chemistry. Till then, take care. Okay, and I request you, students, if you have not subscribed for our beautiful channel, My Exam Coaching, kindly subscribe now and don't forget to press the bell button so that whenever we upload new videos, the first notification will be coming to you. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.